showtime. That's right. And you got the best band. And we in a good mood. That's right. We here to play for you. All right. So let me introduce to you. I'm going to start over here to my left. Your right. Playing your guitar tonight. Standing 6'2". Cap on looking good, y'all. I give to you. See my man, Ellen Little, y'all. Yeah. Hey. Woo. Let me move over here to the baritone sax. 16 years old, ready to put it down for some soul. My man, Dylan. To be with y'all tonight. That's right. Let me give it up to my man, Larry Jackson, y'all. Yeah. Woo! And every band needs a horn section, and we ain't no different. And here we got something special for you, throwing down the alto for you. My man, give it up.
I want you to rock me like my back, and I know, 'cause I want you to rock me. adultery, but very few people are living by the Bible these days. I was a strong believer, but I want to alone. I'm gonna drive somebody else's car, somebody driving mine. Oh Lord. Around some of the nightclubs, I'ma find me somebody, someone that I can love. Next time you see me, bet your life I won't be walking. Between two men, one was a deacon and the other was a member from my church. I heard the deacon tell the member, oh, from now I'm going to my hometown, y'all. I was born in Georgia. I want to take you there. Woo! Lord have mercy. I was way down south, in this little town called Infidelity, Georgia. A beautiful lady came up. She said, you must be Roy C. I said, that's me. I want you to come go home with me. She took me home, laid me down, and we made love. We did it 1,000 times. Can I use your telephone, honey? I wanna call my wife and kid. I got my wife on the phone. I said, I got a flat tire. We don't have but one jack, and it's in your trunk. She said, don't worry about the jack. Get yourself out and walk back. Young lady got me, lay me down in bed again. This time she laid me down on my back. She said, let me get on top. She said, I'ma ride you to California. I told her, ride on. Baby, ride on. Can I use your telephone? I got my wife on the phone again. I said, I got my flat tire fixed. Somehow my motor won't run. But as soon as I get it started, baby, I'm coming home. Oh yeah. Women can lie. Women can laugh when they get in a tight. Let me tell you what happened after this. I was lying there. Somebody knocked on the door. I said, who is it? She said, that's my husband. I said, what I'm gonna do? She said, that's your problem right now. That's when I looked under the bed. The bed was too low. And I looked in the closet. It couldn't hold no more. The only place left to hide, I jumped over the door ledge. And I hid everything but my two balls. The husband walked in. He said, "What's that?" She said, "That's some doorbells I bought from Sis Roba. Those are some strange looking bells. And I wanna hear them ring this morning." See, women can lie when they get in a tight. She stood up and she told him, "Those bells are broke." He said, "How do you know?" She said, "I plugged them in before you got here. And those bells are not working right tonight." And he walked over, he picked up a newspaper. He came back, he hit me across my left ball. He said, "It did not ring. And I want to hear it ring this morning, oh Lord." Then he walked over, picked up a baseball bat. I saw him coming, y'all. And when he got close, he looked up, I looked down. Only thing came to my mind. I said, "Ding dong." Thank you. ever lost anybody? Let me see you raise your hand. Is there anybody out there ever been hurt like me? Let me see your hand. But you know what? I believe I can get my woman back, y'all. If I buy a brand new Cadillac, I believe she'll come back. So that's what I did. I bought a brand new Cadillac. I thought my baby would come back. But you know what? She told me I ain't coming back. No, she said, I won't be back. So here's what I told her. If I can get you to come back to me, I'll do anything you asked of me. Oh, Lord. You know what she told me? Break it down, bam. My woman told me, she said, I'll come back if you go down. I said, what you talking about? She said, I'll come back if you go down. She went, I said, no, no, no. You know what I told her? I don't want my TV. I don't want my telephone. Everything you got, keep it, you go. She's gone.
I was looking for my wife.
but she could not be found nowhere in the house. I went downtown looking everywhere, and I looked, I saw my best friend, and my wife was riding in that car with him. I said, everywhere they go, I'm gonna follow. They went to the Holiday Inn, and I went around to the window, and I peeped in. I saw my wife, and she took off that dress I bought her last week. Then she reached down and took off the pantyhose. A pain hit me right here. I was standing there like a fool, y'all. All I could do, peeping through the window. Policeman came up. He tapped me on my shoulder. He said, I'm gonna lock you up. I said, for what? He said, you're a peeping Tom. I said, uh-uh. Take a look. He peeped in. He said, that's your wife. I said, you're right. And we standing there. He was crying, y'all. I don't know what the hell he was crying about, but he was crying. And I was crying too. I looked down at the policeman. His thing was hard. And I looked down at mine. I didn't have to look. Mine was hard too. Like two fools, side by side, both of us was crying. And I said, peeping through the window, I had enough. I went home, and my wife came home with a smile on her face. And I knew that I did not put it there. And she told me, she said, I want you to leave. I said, I ain't going nowhere. She said, well, I'll pack my bags and I'm gonna leave. I didn't want her to go, because she had something real good and tight. I said, I'ma do everything I can to keep this woman. And I told her, if you don't leave me, I'll buy you a brand new car. She said, nah, not that. If you don't leave me, I'll give you all the money you can spend. She said, I don't want that. I got her. If you don't leave me, I give you what I got down here. She said, I don't want that either. I said, hell, I'm in trouble. I said, but I want to know what's wrong with it. You know, she told me, I don't want to hurt your feelings. I don't want to make you cry. I said, what's wrong with it? She said, if you really want to know, I'll tell you before I go. She said, Roy, your thing is too sharp. That's when I fell out on the floor. The pain was so strong I couldn't take it anymore. So I told her, if you don't leave me, I'll go see Dr. Long John in the morning. Walked in, the doctor took one good look. He said, Roy, you need some help. I said, how much help do I need? He said, 6 more inches on what you got. I said, what it gonna cost? $100 per inch. I said, you kind of high, man. $600. I thought about how good my woman been. I thought about how sweet it is. I said, doctor, make it $1,800. He said, man, he said, you'll be. I said, I can use it. Lord have mercy. Ooh, peeping through the window, peeping through the blind. Thank you. It's still short. loving you. If I could change the way I feel, if I could erase the memory of the first time I saw your face. Pain hurting me deep down inside. Paradise about now.
Give me
and a keyboard. I wanna take you to paradise. Baby, let me take you to paradise. There'll be no more crying, there'll be no more pain, no. Girl, if he hurt you, I won't let him hurt you again. Baby, I wanna be the one, I wanna be the only one, I wanna be the one, I wanna take you to paradise. Oh, blow your horn.
Girl,
We want to do Shotgun Wedding. It's a song I did in 1965.
Before he runs,
There's a train leaving here all in the morning. Oh yeah, I got my ticket. Lord, 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 I'm so gone. Down the street, I'll be somewhere on the train. Lord, said I'm leaving, leaving, said I'm leaving on the train. Oh, yeah. Yeah.